I'm going to tell you 21 things that you need to take care of, or 21 things that you need to keep in mind for the upcoming AIA PGT 2021 exam. And we are starting right now. Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Taha Khan. Welcome to my YouTube channel where I share with you clinic and exam related productivity tips and strategies. If this is your first time here, start now by subscribing and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss anything. First of all, you need to make sure that you are implementing all of these 21 things. Each and every point is important. Don't pick and choose, okay? And if you do so, then it is my guarantee that on 18th of September, that is on the day of the exam, you are gonna give your absolute best performance. The video might get a bit long because I'll be discussing all of these 21 points and all of these points are important. So what I will do, I will divide the video into two parts. Part one is this video and the second part I will be uploading the next week. So listen to all of these things. Few might be very obvious to you. Few might sound new to you, but still ponder over it, because each of these things are gonna be valuable. That I can absolutely promise. So the first point is plan for the next 7 days. The obvious quote that failing to plan is planning to fail. Do not spend your next 7 days randomly. Rather, you should have a plan for each of the, you should have a study plan for each of the next 7 days, what you are gonna study. And not only that, in these 7 days, also plan what you are gonna be studying for the next 30 days that you have before exam. And your plan should be very precise. You should be knowing how many mocks you are gonna give, on which days you will be appearing in mocks, on which days you will be analyzing mocks, when you will be going through the previous year's papers, and these kind of things. Basically, plan meticulously down to the ground level and make sure you execute it. The second point is, what will you be studying in the next 7 days? So I would recommend that in these next 7 days, go through the difficult subjects, the difficult topics, the difficult portions that you find hard to remember, that you keep forgetting. Because that way, what you can do is in the last week, just before the exam, you can again go through these difficult topics so that you will have 2 revisions on these difficult portions just before the exam. And make sure you are studying Materia Medica every day. And not just these 7 days. Make sure that you study Materia Medica. Dedicate few hours every day to Materia Medica for the next 30 days that you have left until exam. Study aphorisms properly. And please make sure that for Organon, you are following the Ari Dajan 5th edition translation book. That is your prescribed book. Don't study from any reference book. Reference book may help you understand it, but for solving MCQ, the only book that is gonna help you is the Ari Dajan, your prescribed test book. You will see in your exam, in Organon, the questions directly come from this book. The next point, very, very important, on the 17th, that is on the night before the exam, sleep like a baby. Don't go into the exam with a sleepy, dull brain. Your mind will not be completely active and you will see that you are making silly mistakes. You are not able to answer things that you already knew. So sleep latest by 10 p.m. on the 17th. And if you want to do an experiment to see how this sleep affects your attempt in the exam, before the exam, any day, sleep for very less one night. Sleep for very less one night and the next day, try to attempt a mock. You will see, you will notice that you are not able to answer the most obvious questions. The answers you already knew very well. You have attempted those answers correctly in the past. But now, because your brain is lacking sleep, your brain is not 100% active, it is in a dull state, you are not able to answer those questions. So do this experiment and sleep properly on the night before the exam. Next is point number 4, the forgetting syndrome. Many of you might be experiencing this now, that you are forgetting a lot of things. The answers that you already knew properly in the past, you are not able to recognize, you are not able to recall those answers now. The mocks that you have attempted correctly in the past, you are scoring less in those mocks now. You have studied these topics in the past, but now when you are looking at it, everything seems new. Don't worry, this is what I call the forgetting syndrome. Because now your brain is in a very stressful situation. You have a lot of pressure. You have, in few weeks, you have your exam. So your brain is not completely able to recognize all that you have studied. Okay, and don't worry, 1 day, 2 day, 3 day before your exam, these things are gonna happen to you, that you will see a topic that you already have studied maybe 10 times, 100 times, but just one day before the exam, this has happened to me also, and it happens to everyone. One day before the exam, when you are looking at it, you are recognizing that you have not even studied this topic. It seems that you don't know anything about this topic. Don't worry, this happens to each and every student who has studied properly. This means that you have studied properly, so you don't have to worry about this. In the exam hall, the point number three that I was speaking about, when your brain is completely and 100% active, you will be able to recall each of these things. So don't worry if this forgetting syndrome is happening to you now. You don't have to panic. You don't have to take stress about it. Just follow the study plan that you have for the next few weeks. The next point. I know this is very obvious, but still I want to talk about it, because every year there are few students who still end up making these kind of mistakes. Read the instructions given on the admit card thrice. Ensure that you are carrying everything that has been mentioned, and also ensure that you are not carrying anything that has been asked to not carry. Ensure that you are carrying the original documents, whatever document that has been asked to carry to bring in the exam hall. Reaching the venue on time, whatever time has been mentioned in the admit card. Ensure that you are reaching the venue way ahead than what has been asked. Ensure everything. See, these are COVID times, so there might be new instructions. So read the admit card thrice. Make a checklist a day before the exam of all the documents that you need to carry. Many of you might be thinking, "Sir, I am smart. I don't need to make any checklist." Everyone is smart until they make mistakes. And today, on the day of exam, you cannot afford a mistake. So that was point number 5, ensuring everything that is written on the admit card. Point number 6, compulsorily carry an analog watch to the exam hall. Digital watch might not be allowed, but an analog watch is not just allowed, it is compulsory for you guys. And in the exam hall, try to keep the watch on the table beside your screen and keep a track of time every 5 to 10 minutes. Make sure you are looking at the watch every 5 to 10 minutes, because this will prevent you from unnecessarily spending a lot of time in one question that you are not able to attempt. And also, you will be going through the entire paper thrice, so you need to make sure that you have time for that. And in one of my previous videos, I will put the link of that video in the description, I have discussed, and that is very important video, every one of you who are appearing in the 2021 exam, I recommend you to go and watch that video, because in that video I have explained how you should attempt the paper in the exam hall. The thing that I just now said, that you are going through the paper thrice, I have discussed in that video why you need to go through the paper thrice. Okay, so you need to make time for that. So watch that video without fail and ensure that you are carrying a big dial analog watch along with you on the day of your exam. So that was point number 6. Now point number 7. Last week I was traveling in Jaipur, and there was this random checking that was going on. They were stopping the cars. They were almost stopping every car and asking for documents, for the car documents, for the license documents, and seeing if the people in the car were wearing masks and all, and these kind of checkings were going on. So luckily we had all the documents, so I was able to pass. But what I saw, that there were few cars that were stopped on the side road, and maybe because they were not able to produce all the documents that were asked for, maybe for some reason, but for whatever reason, there were few cars that were stranded on the road for 30 to 40 minutes. Point is, a lot of you might be traveling that day or the night before the exam. And this is a very small point, but because it happened with me, and I thought that it shouldn't happen to any of the aspirants that are traveling on that day, hence I decided to share it with you. And you also understand that these are COVID times, and in these COVID times a lot of checkings are going on. So make sure that you have all your car documents ready, that you can show whatever documents that are asked for. Make sure everyone in the car is wearing a mask, and don't try to give any logical explanation for that. Just completely avoid it altogether. You might think that this is the most irrelevant of all the 21 points, but because of this one and a half minute talk, even if 5 students got saved, then I would consider it worthy enough. Next, point number 8 is, when should I reach the venue? See, my recommendation is reach the venue 60 to 90 minutes early. 60 minutes is your deadline. No ifs and buts that, sir, what I'll do reaching so early, I'll get bored, I'll feel sleepy. It's not that you are having any prior commitments on that day, right? It's not that I'm having 2-3 meetings in the morning, I'll be signing an important deal on that day, or I'll be meeting up with an important friend on that day after a long time. It's not that. None of you are thinking like that. Had any of you been thinking that way, then you wouldn't have stuck till point 8 with me. See, it's an extraordinary year. There might be extraordinary restrictions. There might be extraordinary checkings. It might take longer than usual to check your IDs. And any unforeseen things might happen, na? There might be some car problems. You might take the wrong route, or the road might be closed. So these things shouldn't impact your exam on that day. And because of these things, if you get late, it will automatically create a stress. And a stress is not good for your exam. So make sure you are reaching on time, and 60 minutes is your deadline. Next, point number 9. Your ancestors have made a lot of mistakes in the past over the course of these years in AIPGT exam. I will talk about few of these mistakes that you should avoid. But this doesn't mean that you will go and make a new mistake. You will make absolutely no mistake. The first is bringing must bahut baniya photocopied koi pehchan nahi sakta almost original ID card. And on top of that, in the exam hall in front of the invigilator, you are justifying that, sir, this is almost original. I have even gotten it laminated. See, original means original. If they have asked you to bring original, then you will have to produce your original ID card. Ultimately, this will fall on the decision of the invigilator. If the invigilator thinks that you should be allowed to sit in the exam, then you can attempt the exam. And if they don't allow, you can do nothing. You can absolutely do nothing about it. You will not be allowed, you will not be able to sit in the exam that year. So original Aadhaar, original PAN, voter ID, driving license, carry all of these original documents. There is a list of documents that you can produce, and I'm sure 2 or 3 of these documents that I just mentioned are in that list. Next is, do not write anything on the admit card, either with pen or pencil. It is strictly prohibited that you should not write anything on the admit card. This incident happened with one of the students in my room. He was what he did. After it was just half an hour, I think, left before the completion of exam. What he was doing that after completing his paper, he began writing few questions. He wrote few questions on the admit card, at the back of the admit card. And this got noticed by the invigilator. Not only his half an hour was wasted, but his exam, his paper got cancelled. You tell me. Is there anything that you can do about that? It is complete decision of the invigilator. If he thinks that your paper should be cancelled, it will get cancelled. You can absolutely do nothing about it. So make sure you are not doing these things, any of these mistakes in your exam. Next is your paper attempting strategy. Now, there is a full-length video which I have made on this particular topic. How you should be attempting your paper. This is a must watch for each and every one of you who are gonna appear in this exam. You will find the link of that video down in the description. Go watch that video without fail. So the basic thing is that by now, all of you might already be having your strategy. You must be having your tried and tested strategy. The only thing that you need to do is go in the exam hall and implement that strategy. You have already done a lot of experiments in the mocks that you have appeared before the exam. And from that, you have made a strategy that, okay, this is the thing that I'm gonna do in the mock. So just go and implement that without improvisation, without doing anything new, without doing any experiment on that day. So just implement the strategy that you already have. Next is expect surprises. And if you are expecting it, then if a surprise comes along, then it won't catch you off guard. This has happened a lot of times in AIPGT in the past 10 years. There has been incidents where there were no questions from FMT. The paper was too difficult. There was too many questions asked from a particular subject. And a lot of similar things like this has happened in the past. And students get panicked. They get panicked inside the exam hall. But what they fail to realize that this has happened to everyone. If there are too many questions asked from a particular subject, then that is for everyone. If there are no questions asked from a particular subject, then that is for everyone. Everyone, this is not a your UBHMS exam. This is a competitive exam. There is no percentage that if you get 40%, then you will pass. If you get 30%, then you will pass. This is a competitive exam. percentile matters. Percentage doesn't matter. Percentile matters. It only matters if you are able to attempt more questions than the other student. That is the main thing. That is the essence of this competitive exam. It is simple math. If the paper is too difficult, then the cutoff will be low. If the paper is too easy, then the cutoff will be high. Like for example, in 2014, the paper was too difficult. It was so difficult that in that year, only 6 students qualified for the exam. Only 6 students got qualified for the exam. Inside the exam hall on that year, when the student got the paper, everyone panicked that how can a paper be so difficult? How can we even attempt? How can we qualify? Everyone was thinking about their qualification. Because the paper was so difficult, everyone was thinking that I will not be able to qualify this exam. But after the exam, when all the students came out and they were discussing with each other, everyone realized that the paper was difficult for everyone, not only for them. Everyone was facing the same situation. Every student were having the same level of stress that they were having. So that is why I want all of you to expect these kind of surprises, so that you make this realization inside the exam hall and not outside the exam hall. Because inside the exam hall, you cannot afford stress. You cannot afford panic. These are not the things that you should be feeling or having inside the exam hall. I think the video has gotten quite long by now. So I'll stop here and discuss the remaining points in the next video, in part 2 of this video. Let me know how you like the video. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. Share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next video.